That should be visible to all of you on board as well. That we are going to start with pH scale. That what is pH, why we are measuring it, and what is the basic purpose of that. So before starting or going towards pH scale, let me clear some important points to all of you. That pH scale is basically used, it is the scale which is used to measure the pH of different compounds. That might be acids, that might be bases, that can be salt, that can be anything. Like if I have given you any kind of solid, any kind of liquid, and any kind of powder, or you just make a mixture of that, and then I said, how much is the pH, please measure it. Then you can easily measure the pH with using pH paper, okay? And you can easily determine the pH of that scale, right? So we are just going towards pH scale, but before that, let me tell you very, very simple and few important points. That pH scale is basically the scale on which we can measure that how much is the acidity of any compound, how much is the basicity of any compound, and either it is neither basic, neither acid, or it is neutral. So the pH scale is basically from 14 and over here 0, and in the middle of that there is 7. The pH scale basically measures from point 0 to 14, and in the middle I have written 7. 7 means if a pH of anything is indicated that it's from 7, it means it is considered as neutral. It means neither it is acidic, neither it is basic. So from 0 to 7, all the substances behave like acidic compounds. Means if pH is from 0 to 7, it is going to be acidic. And if it is above the 7 or 14, it is considered as basic. Means it has more H positive ions and it has more OH negative ions in it. So that's why it is going to be more tendency towards basic character. Now this was the very, very general trend about pH scale. Like if you have any practicals at the end of the exam, then you can be asked by the examiner that what is pH scale. So you should know that what is pH scale, how it comes, and what is the basically purpose of it. ये वो चीजें हैं जो आपको book में मिलेंगी, but regarding Viva point of view, you should be clear from your mind that how you can explain it well to the examiner, और उसके कहीं पे भी marks काटने की गुंजाइश ना रहे. Yeah. Now coming towards that, why we are going to study pH. Now first take the example of water. We say that water H2O ionizes into H plus and OH negative ion. Now there is not any reaction, not any solvent in it. We are just taking water and we are saying this is known as R2. R2 means khud ba khud ho jaye. R2 ionization, or also known as self ionization, means by himself, by itself. Now if we know we have water, definitely water contains H plus and hydronium ion and hydroxyl ion in it. So this equation represents the autoionization or self-ionization of water, right? So according to the base of this autoionization or self-ionization, we can say that the concentration of hydrogen ions in the pure water means distilled water or double distilled water, or not mineral water. Mineral water and distilled water is a changed thing, right? In mineral water, there are little bit minerals like traces of calcium, magnesium, and so many are present over here. But in pure in distilled water, only hydrogen and you can say hydronium ion and OH hydroxyl ions are present. So this is the basis of pH scale, that the concentration of hydrogen ion in the pure water. And how will we write down concentration of hydrogen ion? Like this. This square bracket is representing the active masses or the concentration of hydrogen ions in the water. Now this is the basis of this pH scale. That's why we are going to study. Now you can see that water is a very, very weak electrolyte. Weak electrolyte means in which there is not much tendency to dissociate hurriedly and converting into the other. It dissociates very, very slowly. It is a very weak electrolyte and it only ionizes into two forms, H plus and OH negative. That's why, remember, we said that water is an amphoteric substance. Why? Because it is also giving us hydronium ion and OH negative ion. When it will react with H positive, it is reacting as an acid. When it is reacting with OH negative, it is reacting like a base. So it is an amphoteric compound as well. This was the just recall for the previous one as well. So we can say that ionization or self-ionization is a process by which water is going to be dissociate, and this determination of H positive ion is basically the pH scale basis. Now we can say H2O is going to be dissociate. Down the product over here, H positive, OH negative, and active metal water. This is the equilibrium constant. Remember, in the previous chapter, we have learned that whenever we are going to write down KC, we have to first measure or write down the products on the upper side, and on the lower side, we have to write down the reactant. The same case we have done with over here. Now, but we can say that as concentration of water, H2O, is almost constant. It remains almost constant. Means, jitne bhi idhar moles hain, utne hi moles usme dissociate ho rahi hain. There is not any kind of number of change. If, let's say, yahan par number of moles change ho jati hain, then the equation totally changes. So, we can say that it is remaining constant. H2O is remaining constant. So, we can write it down that KC is equal to KC, water, H2O active mass is equal to OH negative. Means it is remaining constant. So by considering it constant, we will take it over here and remaining equation will be like this. The KC water is constant is equal to H plus and OH negative. Now we can say that a new equilibrium constant, now we can put it over there because this was the equilibrium constant. Now we are talking about the water. So we will replace this H2O with KW and remaining will be over here. I have less space on the board, that's why I am removing it, and we can then introduce KW, small w or not bigger one. KW is equal to H plus OH negative, right? We have replaced KC with KW and we are writing that KW is equal to the concentration of H plus ions and concentration of OH negative ions, and it is equal to KW 1.0 into 10 raised to the power minus 14 at what temperature? At 25 degrees Celsius. Means this is the calculated value for these water example. That equilibrium constant for water is 1.0 into 10 raised to the power minus 14 and the temperature is 25 degrees centigrade. Now we all of you will know that one molecule of water are going to be produced. We know one molecule of water is going to be produced, one H positive and one OH negative, right? I have told you before that one molecule of water is going to be give us one molecule of one, you can say, hydroxyl and one hydronium ion. So we can, on the dissociation, say that H positive is equal to OH negative, right? Jitne hamare paas H positive are going to produce, the same amount is of OH negative. Or we can also say that H positive square is equal to the same value, right? Agar hum isko do martaba le lein, the thing is the same. because H positive is equal to OH negative. That's why we are writing OR. H plus square means there are two H plus, then the ion produced is the same amount. That is there. Now we have to remove the square. Obviously, we will take under root and it will go going to be cut at 10 raised to the power minus 14 and it will going to cut with that. So the answer is hydrogen ion is equal to 1.0 into 10 raised to the power minus 7. 14 will be cutting by square root and it is minus 7 molar. M is the sign that is known as molar. Right? So we can say that therefore hydrogen ion is equal to 1:10⁻⁷ molar and the remaining one is for OH negative or anyone. What is the temperature at 25 degrees centigrade? I hope this will be clear to you that how it comes. I'm explaining it for you that whenever we are having self-ionization of water, I have written the equation, then we have to write down the equilibrium constant. Equilibrium constant always written in such a way that the products are written on the top and the reactants are written on the lower side. Numerator and denominator, you know better. And then we have replaced KC with KW because we are talking about water. The water is H plus OH negative and the value which is calculated by the scientist is 1:10⁻⁴ at 25 degrees centigrade. Now, we all know that there is one molecule of water and when it is going to be dissociated into ions, there will be one H positive and one OH negative. And we can hence say that H positive is equal to OH negative means how many H positives are going to be produced, the same amount of OH negative is going to be produced as well. So we can also write it down H plus square. Now we have to remove this square. We will simply take square root and then we will cut it down and the value comes for H positive minus 1:10⁻⁷ molar. The temperature remains same, that is at 25 degrees centigrade. Now basically this is the value. How can we calculate it? How we can use it? This value is determined by the scientist and it is about very, very old thing. Now what happens, it is really very difficult to deal out the value in which we have minus 7. Because if I said to you that take the amount 10⁻⁷ of this liquid into the beaker, put it there. You can't do it because we don't have that specific instrument to measure in minus 7. We have the instruments, we have burettes and many other things which are graduated, that 7 ml, 10 ml, but we don't have the apparatus or the thing in which we can measure this much amount, minus 7. So for this purpose to calculate, they have some negative exponents and it was convenient, it was easy for all of them to change these figures into a positive figure, means so that we can easily calculate in our laboratories as well. So we will take that it is taking as a common, and you all of you have studied the algebra in computer or might be in definitely in mathematics as well, that when we introduce logarithms. So what is log? We can say that pH is equal to minus log of hydrogen ion, right? So we have introduced to omit that minus sign, we have introduced minus logarithm of hydrogen positive ion. So this is the definition. We can derive that and said that pH is the negative logarithm of molar concentration of hydrogen ion. What is pH? pH is negative logarithm of concentration. This active masses, square bracket is showing the active masses or the molar concentration of hydrogen ion is known as pH. Here, what is pH? pH is negative logarithm of this one, molar concentration of what? Hydrogen ions. But this is pH. You should keep this thing in your mind, and whenever you are going to start the topic of pH, you are supposed to write it down. You have to write down the definition at first, and this is the definition. The pH is negative logarithm of molar concentration. Remember, you have to write down molar concentration. Without it, your definition is incomplete. Molar concentration of hydrogen ion is known as pH. That's why we have representing pH is equal to minus log of hydrogen ion. Now, with reference to the equation, a scale was developed on the basis of this equation. The pH scale was basically developed. And according to that pH scale, the molar concentration of hydrogen on which it was measured, and then they have determined that this is the scale, this is the amount 0 to 14, and 7 is considered as the neutral. Now, well, we can also calculate the pH of water. Now, how we can calculate the pH of water? Just have a look on the board. That we can calculate the pH of water is, we say that minus log of H positive ion. And now we are going to put the value here. That pH is equal to minus log. What was the value we have determined? We have determined the value 1 into 10 raised to the power minus 7. And when we find it out, it will come 7. When we will solve it on your scientific calculator, you can find it out by yourself after the class. Minus log, you will just go in scientific calculator. You will write down this value 1 is to 10 raised to the power minus 7 minus Lazmi calculator, and then you will take a negative log, the value will come to be the 7. So this is the value of water. Now we have to find out, we will like write down similarly, because you know H2O has this dissociation. We have calculated minus log H2O. Now we have to go towards OH negative. How will we do that? Similarly, COH. This was pH. Now COH is equal to minus log of OH negative ion. And we know the values are same. Simply we will put COH is equal to minus log. Value is 1 is to 10 raised to the power minus 7. Hence it is 7. So POH is also 7. And pH is 7. Now what will we do? We will simply find out the value like this. We will say that pH plus POH is equal to 14. 7 plus 7 is equal to 14. And we can hence say that it is at 25 degrees centigrade. And this is all the process of determining the pH of water. This is the first we are going to find out pH of water, then POH, then we will simply plus it, and then we will find out that the value comes is equal to 14. Now what is the purpose? Why we have done it? On the basis of this, we have find it out that there was a scale, and that scale ranges from, we said that pH plus POH is 14, just right, we have done 7 plus 7. Now why we have this? We have do it that pH and POH and we have make a scale of that. 0 to 14 and 14 to 0. The reason is you can also see on your books, let me explain it from there, that if we have the value of 0, 1 and 2, these are considered to be highly acidic. And same in the reverse order, it is more better to understand like this. If I say this is 0, this is 14 and here it is 7. Now, before starting the topic, I have told you that if it is 0 to 7, means 0, 1, 2, if the pH lies in this, it is considered to be highly acidic. It means this acid is very, very acidic. Like HCl, H2SO4, HNO3, all these are having pH in between these ones. Then coming towards 3, 4, and 5, and 6. These are, you can say, these are acidic, but these are lightly acidic. And what about 7? 7 is considered to be neutral, as water is a neutral entity. So similarly, what happens if we go towards 8, 9 and 10? These are considered as slightly basic. And from onward, 13, 14, 11 to onward, these are considered as highly basic character. Means more OH negative ions and more reactivities, like sodium hydroxide, sodium sulfate, all these are in this category in which pH is quite high. So we can say that a solution of a compound in of pH 7 or a POH 7 is considered as a neutral solution, and we have explained it with the help of water. So we can say that solutions of pH that are less than 7 are known as acidic, and solution of POH having more than 7 are known as in basic character. Now there is a diagram on page number 34. You can see and open your books over there. You can see in pink color they have shown that, just like this arrow, they have this one, they have shown the acidic. Just there is a difference between that. They have written on the upper side 14, I have written over here, and this is the character of basic which they have shown with green color, right? So this is that how this is going to affect the pH scale, and that is showing the relation between among H positive or OH negative and POH scale is also going to be shown over here. Now we can say that since the pH scale is the negative logarithm of hydronium ion, we can say that a solution of pH 1 has 10 times a solution whose pH is 1. I have given you a solution and you have to find out the pH. You will say that a pH whose a solution whose pH is 1, it has 10 times higher concentration. It has, jiski pH 1 hai, it has 10 times higher concentration of what? Obviously, pH positive ions than that of jiski pH 2 hai. Because we said 1 is the highly acidic and 2 is also, but not more than 1. Similar, so we can interpret that the pH, the solution whose pH is going to be 1, it is 10 times higher in concentration of H positive ions than the pH of 2, right? So similarly, we can say pH 2 ke baad pH 3 aayegi, and it is going to be 100 times and so on, right? 1000 and then multiplying. So we can say that the low pH values mean stronger acid, while the high pH values mean slightly acidic. Means it's not that gonna strong, more basic towards character on Ashurvajivasta, right? So we can find it out that what we have studied from pH. What is the conclusion? It's written on your book as well that the first thing, we always said the pH of a neutral water is always 7. Neither it's acidic, neither it's basic. Number two, they have said that pH less than 1 and pH greater than 7 is basic character. Right. And we can say on this plus POH is equal to 14, on which basis this pH is going to be determined. Now what are uses of pH? It is very